This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video one for how to graph the cosecant function. In other words, we're going to learn how to graph y equals cosecant of x. You already need to know how to graph the sine function, y equals sine of x, and so make sure you already know that. I have lots of videos on it. First thing to remember is that the cosecant really is the reciprocal of the sine. It's 1 over the sine of x. So in other words, if you know what the sine of x is, then you could just take the reciprocal to get what the cosecant is. And so we're going to use this technique to graph the cosecant. And this is just one technique. We can graph y equals sine of x, but we're going to use dotted lines because that's not really the final graph we want. And then we're going to take the reciprocal of each y-coordinate to graph the y-coordinates for cosecant. All right, so I have drawn the graph for sine of x. Remember, the period is 2 pi. And so the graph for the cosecant of x, since it's just reciprocal, is going to have the same period. So note, it's going to have the same period of pi. I'm sorry, the same period of sine of x. So I'm just going to write that note here. The period should be the same for the sine of x. OK, so we look at this graph here. Now, what I'm saying is we're going to take each y-coordinate and we're going to take the reciprocal of that y-coordinate to actually draw where the y-coordinate is for the secant, which I'm going to do in purple. All right, but notice that I have some of the y-coordinates at 0. For instance, we have 0, 0, we have pi 0, we have 2 pi 0. If we go to the left, we've got negative pi 0, right? Remember, this is negative pi. So there's a problem. We can't take the reciprocal of 0. So any time the sine function crosses the x-axis, that means y is 0, and you're not going to be able to take the reciprocal. There will be vertical asymptotes at those places. All right, so what does that mean? Any time we have a point where the sine x crosses, we're going to make a vertical line through those points. It means that the cosecant will not have any y value there because it's undefined. And you might recall that if you do try to take the cosecant of pi, it's undefined. All right, so the y-axis itself also goes to 0, 0, so that's an asymptote. That one's hard to draw the dotted line because you've drawn a solid line usually for y, but you get the idea. Okay, now let's look at this little space between 0 and pi. If we look at what's going on to the y values, it starts with a very small number. So if I take the reciprocal of a very small number, I get a really big number, right? And then eventually it gets bigger, the numbers get bigger, but when I take the reciprocal, until I get, let's say I'm going up to 1, here's where we've got pi over 2, 1, the reciprocal of 1 is 1. So actually right here, the y value for both the cosecant and the sine are the same. They're both 1. But what about before that? These are very small numbers, right, but still positive. And over here, these are smaller numbers on the right side of this ordered pair. These are also going to be positive when I take the reciprocal. But for instance, let's say one of these numbers was 1/2, then the reciprocal would be 2. Let's say one of these numbers was 1/100, the reciprocal would be 100. And we're just going to get a sketch of this. I'm not even going to put the exact values. It ends up looking something like this, but be careful, it does not cross. So it never crosses that line there. And this is not a parabola. It might look like a parabola, but it actually just gets closer and closer to these dotted lines. Now, what about between pi and 2 pi? Well, here the sine is negative, so the cosecant will also be negative, and the same thing will happen. Right here, this point here, we've got the y value of the sine function, negative 1, and the reciprocal is still negative 1, so that's the same for the cosecant. And then it goes down at this point. And what you see is one period of the cosecant function. All right, now if we go over to the left, This is, you could just start repeating it. Same thing's going to happen. So if you look at this in between 0 and pi, the minimum point for y is 1 at this point, right? And then it goes up forever. If you look over, and notice that was the same as the maximum point for the sine function, right? So if we look between pi and 2 pi over 2, the minimum right point for the y value is negative 1, and that's the maximum point for the cosecant function. Now, so that tells us about the range of the function and also the domain. So let's write down what the domain is. Well, I wasn't able to put any number I wanted in for x, right? There were some problems, like over here at negative pi. Everywhere I have an asymptote, that's not going to be a value I could put in for x. So x will be all real numbers except where I have the asymptotes. All right, so I've moved this graph over here to the right so we would have room to write the domain and range, etc. The domain's complicated because it's like almost all the real numbers, but it doesn't include, you know, negative 2 pi, negative pi, etc. So you notice, those are all multiples of pi. So the domain is all real numbers except. Now, how are you going to write multiples of pi? You could just put k pi, where k is an integer. Now, a way of writing that is a subset of I for integers, or you could write that out in words, where k is an integer. Okay, now the interesting thing is, if you want to know what the asymptotes are, and I'm going to write vertical asymptotes like this. VA is going to stand for vertical asymptotes. So note, VA means vertical asymptotes, because you'll always have some vertical asymptotes for the cosecant. Well, if you look at the domain and you see this exception where k pi is, all you do is write that as x equal. Remember, vertical asymptotes, vertical lines are in the form x equals. X equals exactly what you see right here, k pi, where k is an integer. So they're very related, right? The domain tells you everything it can be, and the vertical asymptotes basically are telling you what it can't be, but you write that as a line. That's an equation of a line. What about the range? Well, it's not every value of y, because notice the sine goes between negative 1 and 1. See the green dotted line, how we started? And there's no values in there. But the values go down, right, forever. Sorry, here we go. The values go down, like if you look at these down here, these are going to go negative infinity forever, but they only go up as high as negative 1, then there's a jump, then they start up at 1 and go forever. So the way to write that is in between negative infinity, it goes up to negative 1, and starts again at 1, and goes to positive infinity. At the beginning, we stated what the period was. It's going to be the same as it is for the sine. So we've got the period is 2 pi. So if it was the cosecant of 2x, we would have to take the sine of 2x, and the period, of course, would change as well. There might also be horizontal translations or phase shifts, or the whole graph may have been cosecant of x plus 5, which means you'd have to sort of move all these y coordinates up 5 spaces, etc. But this is the most basic function, y equals cosecant of x. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.